The American frontier, a symbol of opportunity for a vast majority of settlers. However, today, many don't understand the hardships that came with this territory. In general, exploration has always been a staple of human nature. Its pioneers have helped establish new cultures and tame the land that at the time was unknown.
This particular aspect of human nature was exemplified in the colonial America in the 16th and 17th centuries. The frontier of the Ohio River Valley was one of great controversy. Colonial America was growing exponentially, and the Ohio River Valley was important to the expansion of this new society.
However, at the time, the land was controlled by both the French, who were mainly fur traders, and also the Native Americans that had called the land home for centuries.
Conflict arose quickly between British colonies and the owners of the Ohio River Valley. This conflict led to a bloody French and Indian War. Even after British victory, colonists were not allowed to venture into the frontier that they had fought for. The frontiersmen that slowly made their way into this uncharted and dangerous territory lived lives unlike many other colonists. The most famous of these frontiersmen was Daniel Boone. However, one of the most influential and lesser known was Simon Kenton.
Before we discuss his accomplishments, I'll speak of where this man's life originated.
Simon Kenton was born in the Bull Run Mountains of Virginia on April 3, 1755, to Irish immigrants. His life escalated quickly at the age of 16 when he had killed a man in jealous rage. And in order to escape persecution, Kenton fled into the wilderness of what is now known as West Virginia, Kentucky, and Ohio. During this time in the Ohio River Valley, he changed his name to Simon Butler. After years of living off the land, he only came out of hiding behind this false identity when he discovered the man he thought he had murdered was still alive. Soon after this, in 1774, Kenton served as a scout for the European settlers against the Shawnee Indians in Dunmore's War. During this time, he saved the life of and befriended Daniel Boone. However, after Kenton was captured by the Shawnee Indians, he was tortured in the ways of the natives. One ritual was known as running the gauntlet, which usually caused death for many prisoners. Kenton earned the respect of the Shawnee when he survived this ritual not just once, but 9 times. He was then adopted into the tribe. This occurrence and relationship with the natives was not a common happening in this time period.
The exploration to the west ended up in violence, and relations were far from peaceful.
As Kenton has done many times, he moved on, after promising the Shawnee of his return. This time, he served in the American Revolution as a scout. However, he soon returned to the frontier and explored the Mad River Valley of Ohio, until he joined the War of 1812. He was a general for the Ohio militia, and his experience with the natives in the past greatly enhanced his ability as general. After his many heroic accomplishments, Kenton raised 6 kids.
And his exploration during the early Western expansion helped open the frontier to new settlements. Kenton's unique life should not be placed in accordance with the average colonist.
His perspectives on American frontier and his experience he had with the Native Americans place him among the small percentage of extraordinary frontiersmen.